like I just said, my name is Kassi. I'm currently a PhD student at MIT in chemical engineering. I do research on cancer. I did my undergrad at Northeastern University in Boston, also in chemical engineering. And I'm from Milton, so I'm not too far from here. And some of the stuff I like to do besides engineering is arts and crafts. I like cooking, I like to dance. And I do lots of stuff outside of the lab. I spend a lot of time with my friends. I go on trips. I dress up for Halloween like a unicorn. So I don't spend all my time in lab.
I'm Lynna. I'm also a PhD student at MIT right now, and I'm studying bioengineering. And I'm originally from Canada, so I went to undergrad in Canada, and I recently moved to Boston to do grad school here. And like Kassi, even though I'm an engineer, I also like to do lots of random things. I like all sorts of outdoor activities. I like climbing, hiking, camping, and I recently started playing hockey. So part of the reason why we're here today is we're part of a group at MIT called the Women's Initiative. And what this group is we're a group of students who are all scientists and engineers. And we go and visit schools around the country, so here in Boston, but also everywhere across the United States. And we talk to girls in middle school and in high school to try and get you guys interested in maybe thinking about careers in science and engineering and math.
Okay, so we keep saying STEM. What is STEM? So the letters stand for science, technology, engineering, and math. So that's what the letters actually stand for, but what do people who work in these fields do? So one of the tasks of people who live in these fields are gathering and evaluating evidence. So like making and doing experiments like the people in the picture. And then finally, another big job of people in STEM fields is problem solving. That's one of the biggest things that people in these fields do. So
basically everything you see around you was probably designed or developed in some way by a scientist or an engineer.
A lot of people have stereotypes in their heads when they think about who actually works in STEM. So maybe they think of like someone like Albert Einstein, who was a very famous scientist, but isn't the only kind of scientist there is. Or maybe they assume that everyone who works in the field are like the people on the show, The Big Bang Theory. But the reality is not like this at all. So we're going to highlight some women in STEM who are making huge contributions to the field. And so this woman here, her name is Isis Anchali. She's a software engineer, and her company had put her photo on an ad that was encouraging people to apply to their company. And when this happened, people on the internet started saying mean things. They started saying, "I don't believe you. There's no way that that woman is an engineer. That's not true. She can't be an engineer." And this made her really upset. And so she went online and she started a hashtag, "I look like an engineer." And she encouraged people who work in STEM to post their pictures with the hashtag "I look like an engineer" to show that there's no one way to look or be or anything like that to work in STEM. That basically you, like anyone at all, works in this field, and that the stereotypes aren't true. France Angelini Cordova is the current director of the National Science Foundation, and she's the first Hispanic woman to hold this position. And so not only is she in charge of the foundation and the government that helps fund research all over the country, but she's also making huge contributions to making sure that scientists from diverse backgrounds are able to participate in science.
that you really have the chance to make an impact on society. You can build things that people use every day. You have the chance to direct what future technology is going to look like. So you really get to be at the front of all sorts of innovation and create new things. Another huge contribution that engineers and scientists are working on, a huge problem that they're trying to solve, is this energy crisis. So how can we find clean ways to create energy using renewable resources such as the wind or the sun? And so you've probably seen windmills like this before, and that's the work of scientists and engineers. So there's a lot of science there. So figuring out what's the best shape in order to harness the most wind possible, figuring out what materials to use so that the windmill doesn't break down, for example, and then figuring out how do we actually get that wind energy and translate it into electricity that we can use to turn on the lights. So you could also be a researcher in a lab. So researchers will perform experiments to discover new things or to learn about new reactions or new molecules. So we're going to do an experiment later today that gives you a feeling for what it might be like to work as a researcher in a lab.
Small to see, but together they